Hi students, today we are going to solve the textbook question of haloalkanes and haloarenes. So look at this example. We need to do dehydrohalogenation of 2-chloro-2-methyl-butane. As soon as you see the word dehydrohalogenation, two important points come to our mind. The first one is beta elimination, which is done using the reagents alcoholic KOH, which is potassium hydroxide, followed by heating. First, we need to identify the mechanism. Second important thing is, and rule is applied, we call that as Sayce's rule. So, using these two information, it is possible to do dehydrohalogenation. D means removal, hydro means hydrogen, and halogen, both hydrogen and halogen is removed from this compound so that you get an alkene. So let us move on to getting the products. First, draw the structure correctly. Second position, we have a chlorine and a methyl group. The remaining should be filled with hydrogens. So most of the time you make a mistake of putting a hydrogen here. Here already carbon is satisfying the valency of 4, therefore no need to put any hydrogen in this carbon, which is very important to note. Okay, the next step is identify the alpha position. The functional group is chlorine, the attached carbon is alpha. Adjacent positions, that adjacent to the alpha carbon, we have 3 beta carbons noticed. As a result, if you really notice, these two beta position has the same environment carbon, whereas this beta position has 2 different environments. Therefore, I am going to get 2 products here. The 2 products are, first removing from here one of the hydrogen and halogen, we get CH2, there is a double bond formed between alpha and beta, then carbon with CH3 and then CH2, CH3. The second structure is removing the hydrogen from here so that you get a double bond between alpha and beta. Therefore, the answer will be CH3, CCH3, then you get a double bond here, then CH, CH3. The first thing is identify the products properly. Removing the hydrogen from the alpha beta position and removing the chlorine from the alpha position results in a double bond between alpha and beta. Now, if I look at this particular structure and block the double bond, see here, if I block the double bond, I find 1 methyl group attached to the carbon-carbon double bond. In this structure, there is only 1 methyl group attached to the carbon-carbon double bond. But if I block this carbon-carbon double bond, I find 1 methyl group, there is second one, and 3 methyl groups are attached to this carbon-carbon double bond. According to the Sayce's rule, more the methyl groups attached to the carbon-carbon double bond, that will be considered as the major product. Therefore, this structure is a major product, whereas this structure is a minor product. Because in this structure, you will notice that 1 carbon-carbon double bond is surrounded by 1, 2, 3, 3 methyl groups, which satisfies Sayce's rule. Hope you understood, children. Please practice to get better performance. Thank you.